Hello students, today we are going to solve examples based on internal and external bisectors of an angle of a triangle. So first example is the bisector of interior angle of triangle ABC meets BC in D and the bisector of exterior angle A meets BC produced in E. Prove that BD by BE is equal to CD by C. So first we draw diagram. So here this is triangle ABC. So we draw like this way. Suppose ABC is a triangle and AD is interior bisector of angle A. And if we extend this BA, then exterior bisector meets BC produced in E. So here E is the exterior bisector and AD is the interior bisector of angle A. Okay, so we have to prove that this BD by BE is equal to CD by CE. So this is exterior bisector, so we represent this AE as a dotted line. So AE and AD are external and internal bisectors. So we have to write here given that is AD and AE are bisectors of interior and exterior of angle A. Interior and exterior of angle A. So AE is exterior bisector and AD is interior bisector of angle A. We have to prove this. BD by BE is equal to CD by CE. So BD by BE is equal to CD by CE. Now we have to prove this. So proof. So first, in triangle ABC, AD is interior bisector of angle A or bisector of interior angle A. So in triangle ABC, or we can write it like this way. In triangle ABC, AD is bisector of interior angle A. Then we can write by interior bisector theorem, AB by AC is equal to BD by DC. AB by AC is equal to BD by DC. So we give here number 1. So AB in triangle ABC, AD is bisector of interior angle A. Therefore, by interior bisector theorem, we can write AB by AC is equal to BD by CD. Similarly, here AE is a bisector of exterior angle A. So by exterior angle theorem, bisector angle theorem, we can write AB by AC is equal to BE by CE, because here E divides BC externally. So we can write AB by AC is equal to BE by C. So here we give number 2. So from 1 and 2, this left hand side is equal AB by AC. So therefore right hand side also equal. So from 1 and 2, we can write BD by DC is equal to BE by C. Now we want here BD by BE. So only we have to shift this BE here and DC we have to shift here. So BD by BE is equal to CD by or DC by CE. So this is our proof. Okay, now we will see next example. Okay, second example is if the diagonal BD of quadrilateral ABCD bisects both angle B and D, show that AB by BC is equal to AD by CD. So first we draw a diagram. So this is called lateral ABCD and diagonal BD bisects angle B and angle D, means these two angles equal and these two angles also equal. So BD bisects angle B and angle D. So here we have to construct only, we have to join AC, A and C, which intersects BD at point O, suppose. So now we have to prove this. AB by BC is equal to AD by CD. So first we have to write D1. Here D1 is diagonal BD of a quadrilateral ABCD. Bisects angle B and angle D. Then what we have to prove, here it is given, to prove AB by BC is equal to AD by CD. So we have to construct here. So we have to construction is there. We have to join A and C. So join AC, which intersects BD at O. Okay, now we have to prove this. So proof is easy, only we have to use internal bisector theorem. So in triangle ABC, OB is the bisector, because here BD bisects angle B and angle D both. So in triangle ABC, OB is bisector of angle B. Therefore, we can write AB by BC is equal to OA by OC. So this is first one. Second, if we consider triangle ADC, so in triangle ADC, now BD is bisector, means here DO also bisector of angle D. So we can write OD is bisector of angle D. So therefore we can write AD by DC is equal to OA by OC. So from one and two we can write, so from 1 and 2 we can write OA by OC, this RHS is equal in both equations. So we can write AD by BC is equal to AD by BC. So we have to prove this same, AB by BC is equal to AD by DC. So AB by BC is equal to AD by DC or CD. Now we will see next example. Okay, third example is ABCD is a quadrilateral in which AB is equal to AD, the bisector of angle BAC. So here BAC is a, this angle is BAC and bisector of angle BAC is AE given, and angle CAD, bisector of angle CAD. So here bisector of angle CAD is AF. Bisector of angle BAC and CAD intersect the sides BC and CD at E and F respectively. We have to show that EF parallel to BD. So here given is this, in quadrilateral ABCD in which AB is equal to AD, bisector of BAC and CAD intersect the sides BC and CD at E and F. So I am not writing here given. We have to prove that EF parallel to BD. So I am writing only this, to prove EF parallel to BD. Okay, we have to construct only this BD, we have to join, and directly I am writing here proof. So here given is all this, ABCD is quadrilateral in which AB is equal to AD, bisector of BAC and CAD intersect sides BC and CD at E and F. We have to prove EF parallel to BD. Construction, join this BD. Now we have to prove that EF parallel to BD. Now we have to start from this. AE is the bisector, AE is bisector.
First we have to write
triangle. So this triangle we have to consider, triangle in triangle. In triangle BAC, this triangle we have to consider. So in triangle BAC, AE is bisector of angle BAC. So if A is bisector of angle BAC, by bisector theorem, interior angle bisector theorem, we can write AB by AC is equal to, AB by AC is equal to B by C. This is B by CE. Okay. Now again, we have to consider this triangle, triangle ADC. So in triangle here we have to give one. In triangle ADC, AF is bisector of angle DAC or CAD. Then we can write AD by, or here we can write AD by AC. AD by AC. AD by AC is equal to DF by FC. So this is equation 2. Now this, or here we can write, replace this. We know that here AB is equal to AD. So this AD we can replace by AB. So instead of AD we can write AB. So AB by AC is equal to DF by FC. This is equation 2. And reason here we can write AB is equal to AD. Now from 1 and 2, here left hand side is equal, therefore we can equate right hand side. So from 1 and 2 we can write, from 1 and 2, B by C is equal to DF by FC. B by CE is equal to DF by FC. So here if we consider this triangles BCD, B by CE is equal to DF by FC. So if we consider triangle BDC, and if we consider this ratio, then we can write by converse of BPT this EF parallel to BD, because here B by CE is equal to DF by FC. So by converse of BPT we can write EF parallel to BD. So we can consider this triangle. In triangle BDC, B by CE is equal to DF by FC. Therefore, by converse of BPT, we can write EF parallel to BD. So we have to prove this EF parallel to BD. So this is the proof. So by converse of BPD we can write EF parallel to BD. Now we will see next example. Okay, fourth example is O is any point inside a triangle. So O is any point inside a triangle ABC. The bisector of angle AOB, AOB, BOC and AOC meet the sides AB, BC and AC at point D, E and F respectively. We have to show that AD into B into CF is equal to DB into EC into AF. So here again we have to use this internal angle bisector theorem. So here I am writing directly solution. Here in triangle AOB, OD is bisector. OD is bisector of angle AOB. Therefore we can write OA by OB is equal to AD by DB. So this is equation 1. Similarly, in triangle BOC, OE is bisector of angle BOC. write here OB by OC is equal to BE by EC. So OB by OC is equal to BE by EC by internal bisector theorem. Similarly, in triangle AOC, OF is bisector. Here you have to give 2. In triangle AOC, OF is bisector of angle AOC. So here we can write OC by OA. Here in triangle AOC, OF is bisector. Therefore, we can write OC by OA is equal to CF by OC by OA is equal to CF by AF. So this is equation 3. Now we have to multiply all these 3 equations side by side. So multiplying 1, 2 and 3. So if we multiply this OA by OB, multiply with OB by OC, multiply with OC by OA is equal to RHS AD by DB, multiply with BE by EC, multiply CF by AF. Now in RHS all these terms will get cancelled. This OA, OB, OB and OC will be cancelled. So here one remain and here AD into BE into CF divided by DB into EC into AF. Now if we shift this term here, so we will get BD into EC into AF is equal to AD into BE into CF. So this we have to do. AD into BE into CF. So AD into BE into CF is equal to BD into EC into FA. So BD into EC into FA or AF. So now we will see next example. Okay, next example is AD is the median of triangle ABC. The bisector of angle ADB and angle ADC meet AB and AC in E and F respectively. Prove that EF parallel to BC. So first we have to draw a diagram. So triangle ABC. ABC is triangle, then AD is median and bisector of angle ADB and ADC meet AB and AC in E and F. So this is bisector, suppose meet AB at E and here DF is bisector of angle ADC meet AC in F. We have to show that EF parallel to BC. So we have to join this EF. Now given is all this, the bisector of angle ADB and ADC meet AB and AC in E and F respectively. We have to prove EF parallel to BC. Now we have to start proof. So here in triangle ADB, D is the bisector of angle ADB. So in triangle ADB, DE is a bisector of angle ADB. So therefore we can write AD by DB is equal to AE by EB. This is equation 1. Similarly, in triangle ADC, DF is bisector. So in triangle ADC, DF is a bisector of angle ADC. So therefore we can write AD by DC is equal to AF by FC. Now here DB and DC, these two are equal because AD is median, means D is midpoint, so DB and DC are equal. So this DC we can replace as DB. So AD by DB is equal to AF by FC. So here reason we can write AD is median. So AD is median means D is midpoint and DB and DC are equal. So this is equation 2. Now from 1 and 2, this LH is equal. So RH is also equal. So we can write from 1 and 2, A by EB is equal to AF by FC. So here we will get AE by EB is equal to AF by FC. So if we consider triangle ABC and if we consider this ratio AE by EB is equal to AF by FC, so we can write by converse of BPT EF parallel to BC. So in triangle ABC, AE by EB is equal to AF by FC, therefore by converse of BPT we can write this EF parallel to BC.